Bartonella is a genus of gram-negative bacteria that are primarily transmitted to humans through insect and animal vectors, such as cats, dogs, ticks, fleas, and body lice, although there may be other vectors. These can cause a variety of different acute and chronic presentations that can sometimes lead to treatment-resistant conditions that require an advanced approach. Bartonella can be significant in neurological disease through a variety of mechanisms. There can be direct infection of nerve cells peripherally as well as centrally. And a lot of the symptoms and presentations that we may see with neurological disease secondary to Bartonella are the result of whether or not the central nervous system is infected or primarily the peripheral nervous system. It can persist within endothelial cells, which can affect vascular function throughout the body. They can also pers it can also persist in erythrocytes or red blood cells, which can affect oxygenation and the clotting cascade in various parts of the body. There can be damage to the blood-brain barrier. There can be disruptions in vascular endothelial growth factor or VEGF, which can lead to increased angiogenesis and further disruption of the blood-brain barrier. We also tend to see a lot of digestive issues like gastroparesis and recurrent small intestinal bacterial overgrowth. There were a couple of cases where we were treating a patient with a traditional SIBO protocol and they were not getting better. And then we switched them to antibiotics that we would use for Bartonella because the patients had tested positive for Bartonella and their SIBO symptoms got significantly better. With central nervous system infection with Bartonella, we tend to see a lot of psychiatric symptoms. This may look like irritability and rage without a clear explanation, or trigger. We may see severe anxiety or mood disorders that are not responsive to psychotropic medications, and we may see cognitive dysfunction as well as fatigue. We also may see exacerbation of pre-existing mood disorders, anxiety disorders, or cognitive or attentional disorders. Peripherally, we may see sensory neuropathies like paresthesias or loss of sensation, and we may see autonomic dysfunction, including vagus nerve dysfunction, postural orthostatic tachycardia syndrome, or issues with digestion. When a patient presents with symptoms suggestive of inflammatory causes or inflammatory contributors, for lack of a better word, that's when I'm thinking, is there an infection or is there an environmental toxin that may be contributing to their persistent symptoms? This is especially relevant if they are not responding to conventional psychopharmacology. If they tend to respond favorably to anti-inflammatory medications or integrative treatments or antimicrobial treatments, like such as if they were taking an antibiotic for a sinus infection and their depression got better. These are things that might tip the scale in favor of evaluating for Bartonella. When I'm suspecting Bartonella, there can be a lot of cross-reactivity in terms of symptom presentation, with Lyme disease, Mycoplasma pneumoniae, Babesia, Anaplasma, and Ehrlichia. Essentially, other tick-borne or other animal and insect-transmitted infections. There have been times where I thought for sure this is Bartonella, and they end up testing negative for Bartonella and positive for Babesia. Or I thought for sure this was Babesia because of the classic presentations there, and it ended up being Bartonella. So we really do need to take a broad look if we want to be as accurate as possible in our final assessment. So recently, I had a 28-year-old female patient with severe anxiety and mood instability. She was working with one of our psychiatrists with medications for that. And we were seeing some improvement, but a lot of her symptoms suggested an inflammatory root cause because they developed after she was away at summer camp and got bit by an unknown insect. In subsequent years following that, she had severe mold exposure. So at first, when she started seeing me, I thought, we need to address the mold toxicity piece. But it wasn't until we determined that she had a Bartonella infection that we were able to focus more specifically on some of the infectious triggers. I gave her an herb called Japanese knotweed, which has broad spectrum activity against a variety of vector-borne infections. And we began the dosing very low, which we often need to do when dealing with psychiatric manifestations. And she reported that her anxiety was lower than it had been in 10 years after just a few days of Japanese knotweed. The treatment timeline did not play out linearly. There were ups and downs along the way, but it was very interesting for her and for me to notice such a significant reduction in her anxiety when we began treatment. I love Galaxy Diagnostics because they are the only company that offers quantitative serology, which means we actually get a number that we can track with antibody responses over the course of treatment. They also offer direct detection methods that are more sensitive than some of the other available tests on the market, which allows us to get a complete view because some patients do not show an antibody response to these infections, while we can detect them through direct detection means.